Thank you for wearing your masks. If you saw the message sent out earlier this week, you will know that our bishop has mandated we are all to be back in masks. So the only time you will see me or Deacon Lisa unmasked or a lector is obviously when we're trying to do this and not yell through the mask, but we're very well spaced. So thank you again for that. Our opening hymn will be on the screen this morning, so we don't need our books. Let us continue in holy worship. Known and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, we pray the Spirit to think and do always those things that are right, that we, who cannot exist without you, may by you be enabled to live according to your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us prepare ourselves to hear the word of God as it comes to us in the reading of Holy Scripture.
Our hearts and minds are open.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. "It is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the broom tree and fell asleep. Suddenly an angel touched him and said to him, "Get up and eat." He looked, and there at his head was a cake bread on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and lay down again. The angel of the Lord came a second time, touched him and said, "Get up and eat, otherwise the journey will be too much for you." He got up and ate and drank. Then he went into the strength of that food for 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb and the Mount of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in reading Psalm 34, verses 1 through 8 in your bulletin. I will bless
the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth. I will glory in the Lord. Let the humble hear and rejoice. Proclaim to me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord. Look upon him and be radiant, and let not your face be ashamed. I call my affliction, and the Lord heard me, save me from all my troubles. The angel of the Lord comes to those who fear him, and he will deliver them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who trust in him.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. So then, putting away falsehood, let all of us speak the truth to our neighbors, for we are members of one another. Be angry, but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger, and do not make room for the devil. Thieves must give up stealing. Rather let labor and work honestly with their own hands, so as to have something to share with the needy. Let no evil talk come out of your mouths, but only what is useful for building up, as there is need, so that your own words may give grace to those who hear. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were marked with a seal for the day of redemption. Put away from your bitterness and wrath and anger and wrangling and slander, together with all malice, and be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ has forgiven you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love, as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." Then the Jews began to complain about him because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." They were saying, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose mother and father we know? How can he now say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered them, "Do not complain amongst yourselves. No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise that person up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'And they shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Very truly I tell you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread shall live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. I don't know about you, but I enjoy a good movie. It can always so be fun when those movies turn into trilogies, right? And there's three of them to tell the whole story, like Lord of the Rings, or one of my all-time favorites, The Matrix. You guys remember that old, it's considered a classic now. Do you know The Matrix? Oh, praise God. Okay, if the 20-something knows The Matrix, we should all remember way back, Keanu Reeves, you know. All right, so if you've never seen the movie, I encourage you highly, I recommend it very much, but you have to watch all three or you just don't get it. Sorry, that's the way it goes. Why am I bringing up The Matrix in a trilogy? Because we are in a trilogy here. We started last Sunday and we will end next Sunday. We are looking at the Gospel of John, chapter 6, these specific verses for 3 whole weeks. So somebody in the church and moved by the Spirit of God thinks this is really important stuff and we need to pay attention to it. But before we get to John and Jesus, I want to back us up just a little bit and remember last Sunday so we can get into this Sunday. Last Sunday we started in the Old Testament and we talked about the miracles that God had done to bring those Israelites out of Egypt, out of slavery, part one of their trilogy, right? Into the wilderness where they were complaining that they had nothing to eat. Part two of the trilogy, right? We know what happened in the very end, part three, they actually get out of the wilderness and they go on and all of that stuff is wonderful. But they were being human beings and they were hungry. And so what did God do? He answers by feeding them with the bread of angels, manna from heaven. Today, we start here in 1 Kings, and we have another story very similar. Only this time, it's with the prophet Elijah. He's the first one. He's going to train up Elisha a little later. We'll get there, but not today. Today, we're with Elijah. And again, we are in the middle of his story. See, what we don't know, because we didn't read it this morning, we might not remember, so I'm going to remind us, what was the first part? The first part was 1 Kings chapter 18, and Elijah ruled the day. With the power of God coming down in fire, he banished all the priests of Baal. Remember that story? And now he's running for his life across the kingdom of Israel. That's a multi-day job, folks. Well, he's already gotten about a fourth way through. And we catch up with him this morning, and we hear him saying, "Enough! I can't do it anymore. I'm done. I'm going to lay under this boom tree, big shade tree, and I'm ready to die. You just take me home. We've done great. And he goes to sleep. He is human. He's exhausted. But notice what has happened. He had this amazing success in his life, and now he's complaining because the reality he envisions is not the reality he got. The reality was all of the prophets of Baal are gone, so now all the prophets of God should be able to stand up. Nope, that's not really the reality. The reality now is that the king and queen, Jezebel, remember her? Ooh, she was a trip. She's out to get revenge on all the prophets of God, including Elijah. And so he's running for his life, and he's ready to give up. And what does God do? God taps him on the shoulder by a messenger. The Hebrew word, malak, it means messenger or angel or person of gift, person with good news to bring. This person taps him. Wake up, Elijah. Wake up and eat. So what does Elijah do? He wakes up, he eats, he drinks the water, and he immediately falls back to sleep. That's how tired this man is. And it happens a second time, and now he eats and he drinks and he regains his strength, so much so he is able over the next 40 days to cross the entire nation, bringing the good news with him as he went. Because that's what God does. God continues to show up in the middle. You and I have successes. For example, in 2004, you might recall, the Episcopal Church was in rather a complicated upheaval place. Some of us were graduating seminary. And because of that upheaval in the church, people were locking up their wallets. And when you lock up your wallet, all of the jobs that we new graduates thought we were going to get, which was being an associate or an assistant priest, those jobs were gone. I remember looking at all of my friends, and we're wondering, okay, now what? Because at that time, seminary was preparing you to become the assistant so you could learn on the job in order to then someday become the priest in charge, rector. But you weren't supposed to just graduate and there you go. We got a call, literally, from my bishop at that time, not in this diocese, different diocese. And my bishop called and said, I have no jobs for you. You are released. You are free. Go where God sends you. Literally, my husband and I celebrated. We were excited. We're free. We can go wherever God calls us. This is exciting. And we did. We kind of popped the cork, if you know what I mean. And we were celebrating and had a great meal that night. We got up the next morning, and just like Elijah, we looked at each other in terror. Wait a minute. We can't go home. Where are we supposed to go? 1 minute success, the next minute absolutely abject terror. That's life. It's called being human. It happens every day. 1 minute we're the hero in the first movie, and in the next moment we're somewhere in the middle of the trilogy. And God does not choose to illumine the end of the movie. And what we picture as being reality often isn't what is reality. We get confused and downhearted, and that is where we pick up with Jesus this morning. See, last Sunday we ended with exactly where we started today. If you were here last Sunday, you know that. We ended with that verse. Jesus said unto the crowds, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. That's where we ended, remember? And we know that Jesus had just come off a huge win, successful first movie. He had just fed 5,000 people. And they were all following him and eager to see more signs. And then we find ourselves in the middle. What will happen next? And now we have this conversation between Jesus and the people. But
But we missed some verses this morning, verses we actually get to hear next week. But I'm going to read them to you so you know what's coming at the end of the trilogy. Whoever, Jesus continued, comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes will never be thirsty. And then he said, you that have seen me, and yet you don't believe. You need to believe, because everything the Father gives me will come to me. Anyone who comes to me, I will never drive away. I have come down from heaven, not to do my will, but to do the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of God, that I would not lose anyone that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day, and that all who believe may have eternal life. That's the end. That's next week. I come back. We'll hear it again. So what happens? We jump to the middle. Today, we got the people complaining, because here's Jesus talking about, I'm the one, I came down from heaven, I am the bread of life, I offer eternal life. And what did the people answer with? Complaining. Because the reality that they thought would be is not the reality they're getting. I mean, listen to what they're talking. Wait a minute! That's Jesus. Y'all know Jesus. You saw him grow up in Nazareth. That's Mary and Joseph's boy. That's the carpenter's kid. We watched him play, kick the can down the road with all the other boys. We know how he grew up. What do you mean you came down from heaven? How do you have the power of eternal life? Right? That's really what's happening, because being human, we're stuck in the human. We only comprehend what we see as being earthly reality. And God's reality is not ours. And God doesn't always choose to illuminate it so that we can see the heavenly that's coming. We don't always understand what it means to receive the gift of life, the bread of life. We live in the middle. I don't know if you've been watching the news lately, but I have. Large lakes that have always had water no longer have water. There is no lake. Places are on fire. Some of those places are always on fire, it seems. But the fires are continuing. I can't tell you the last time I remember Hawaii being on fire. I know it's happened, but my goodness, what tragedy. An entire town in California has been wiped out this week. Storms across the Midwest, tornadic tragedies. There's not just one volcano in an area, there are two erupting that people are having to flee from. And then throw that on top of the pandemic, which as a whole, the world cannot seem to get a grip on. We cannot seem to control this horrible virus. And that's just on top of everyday yuck. Everyday realities of the homeless, of children who will be starting school that are hungry. We know this. We are living in the middle. Our Jesus has come, and he has taught the words of freedom and words for salvation. And we know that he will come again in his glorious might. But we get the middle. And it is in the middle where God continues to send his messengers of the good news, his angels, to provide the food that you and I need to eat. Not simply to feed our tummies and live, but to feed our very souls. You and I have an action and a response that is required of us every day to live for that gospel good news. Because we don't know when we're going to be the ones that God taps to go be the messenger of the good news. And some of us today may feel it tugging on our hearts that I need to respond in such a way that that does something to help those who are in need after mass natural disasters and destruction. Maybe you feel called to reach out to the Episcopal Relief and Development and give a check that way. Or maybe it is as simple as wearing our masks and not complaining. Let's face it, we all hate them. I know that you do. I know that I do. I am not excited to have to put it back on. But I don't put it on because it's a political statement. It has nothing to do with politics. I put on my mask because I love you. And I love every man, woman, and child that I meet in the stores or wherever I might find myself. I do it out of love. The way you and I are called to live is not in response to our politicians. They are men and they are women, and they were put in their role by God to do that job for their time. We are to pray for them. We are to respect them. But my friends, they're just as human as you and I, and they make mistakes and we make mistakes. Because we're all just human. We are called to live a different way. We're called to live in the will and walk of Christ. We have to lay down our politics. We've got to lay down the arguing. We need to get ready to lay down our life for another person. It's not my will, Lord, but your will. Your will. God, what would you have me do today? Let me be an angel of good news to someone else who's hurting. They need to hear a message of love. To someone else who might be sick or dying, they need to hear the message of healing. To someone else who is feeling very hopeless, we can be the messengers of hope. Amen.
Amen.
Confident in God's love in Jesus Christ, let us pray for the world and for our needs, saying, Merciful God, hear our prayer. God, you have called forth the church to embody your way of life. Help those who profess faith in Christ to be faithful disciples and live according to your word. We pray especially for Carla, Richard, and Lisa. for Michael and Dabney, for our Bishop Coadjutor Search Committee. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for St. Clement's Tampa, St. Thomas Chapel and Parish Episcopal Church, Parish, St. David's Englewood, St. Edmund's Arcadia, St. Elizabeth's Zephyr Hills, St. Francis, Tampa, and Dayspring Conference Center. In our Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the Church of South India, for all who follow Christ. Merciful God, hear our prayer. Your children imitate you by speaking truth and showing forgiveness and providing a loving community of hope. We remember those on our parish prayer list: Anne, Jackie, Jan, Kimberly, Karen, Natasha, Myra, Zeke, Elizabeth, Al, Carol, Dick, Sarone, Shirley, Travis, Skip, Pam, Ed and Edie, Bobby, Heather, and Stuart. And for Jean, Claudia, Chris, Jamie, Crystal, and Melanie. We give thanksgiving for the birth of Maya, for our neighbors and our neighborhoods, that we may live in peace and in true community. Merciful God, God, our civic leaders face daily challenges and temptations. For government officials, especially Joe and Ron, and for those in the military, Miguel, Charles, Travis, Mike, and Matt, may they have hearts of integrity and wisdom of judgment in their performance of their public service. Merciful God,
hear our prayer.
God, the people of earth hunger for the spiritual food you provide that gives meaning to life. But many are hungry for good bread and safe drinking water and for the bare necessities of life. We pray for our outreach ministries, Crafters for Hope, Shure, St. Wilfrid's Food Pantry, and Ashton Elementary School. For those who struggle against the dehumanizing power of poverty, and for those who pursue justice in the sharing of earth's resources, merciful God, God, your world is filled with the delights of natural beauty, but also the danger of natural disaster. We pray especially for those in the path of fires, tornadoes, volcanoes. For the planet Earth, our home, that people dwell in peace with the land, honoring its beauty, conserving its resources, and respecting its power. Merciful God, God, we entrust to your never-failing care and love those who have died, especially Sally and Gil. Receive them into the arms of your mercy and remember them according to the favor you bear for your people. Merciful God, merciful God, hear the prayers of your people and grant that what we ask in faith we may receive according to your gracious love through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us continue with our Growing in the Spirit prayer. Almighty and ever-living God, source of all wisdom and understanding,
be present with us as we consider the renewal and mission of our congregation. Teach us all things to seek first your honor and glory. Guide us by your Holy Spirit to perceive what is right, and grant us all the courage to perceive it and the grace to accomplish it through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone.
We have not loved you with our whole heart.
We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly regret.
For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ,
have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
As we pass the peace, please recognize your neighbor might only want to pass the peace. Pass the peace. Pass the peace, okay? The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
God's peace. So thankful the choir's back too. Welcome everyone. We do have coffee hour. I've been asked, so I'm just trying to hit all the questions. No, at this time we have no plans to separate chairs or go any further beyond please wear our masks. So, which is, you know, that's pretty simple. We can all do that. This week, in case you're not in the loop with schools, like some of us are, school for Sarasota County begins on Tuesday. So remember, we got kids waiting at bus stops and all that good stuff. Be patient if you're out there. Look for the little guys. We're going to pray for them and for their teachers. And then, of course, college students have been already starting. And some, like my daughter, don't start for a couple more weeks. But it's all going on. So let's lift them all in prayer. Eternal God, bless all schools, colleges, and universities. Especially our students and children and teachers that worship among us here at St. Margaret's, that they may be lively centers for sound learning, new discovery, and the pursuit of wisdom. Grant that those who teach and those who learn may find you to be the source of all truth through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So we're glad that they're getting back. I mentioned in the sermon ERD, Episcopal Relief and Development. That is one way to give, if you feel so called, to respond to things like natural disasters in our world. Please do not give your check to St. Margaret's. To give to Episcopal Relief and Development, you have to go online. And it's really, if you start Googling Episcopal Relief, boom, it pops right up. You're going to get ERD. And you can give through their website that way. I can talk to you further if you have more questions. Reminder, our offertory plate is in the back. I was hoping by now we'd be able to start, but if we're all wearing masks, I'm not going to start passing the plate yet. So it's back there, and next Sunday, the outreach basket will be with it. It's Celtic Sunday. Let's get back into wearing our tartan or wearing our St. Margaret shirts. I think it's important that we kind of give ourselves a little oompa shot, right, of joy and celebration. So we're going to do that, and remember that our outreach this month goes to support Ashton Elementary, and we'll be doing that. But every time the basket's out on Celtic Sunday, outreach goes for the school ministry. It goes to Crafters for Hope, our cancer care ministry. It goes to our justice ministry through SURE. It also goes to support our deacon and her ministry when she has persons who come to her with needs. She's able to use those funds, too, to help assist. It might be a gas card or a grocery card or things like that. So that's her discretionary funds. So thank you for giving so generously. Are there announcements I am forgetting? All right. Then this shampoo. Oh, is that this month, shampoo?
Yes. St. Wilfrid's has gone back to the previous distribution method, but our monthly contributions of shampoo this month are going to be greatly appreciated as people are now allowed back in the building and they're basically shopping the parish hall over at St. Wilfrid's as if they would a grocery store. So Assistance is needed on Thursday afternoons to set that up, and assistance on Friday afternoons to help people get through the lines. So thank you.
Thank you. And when we think shampoo and conditioner, I'm going to put in two plugs. Yes, we need adult shampoo and conditioner. That's always great. And I say conditioner because some of us need it and some others never use it. But don't forget the children. If you feel so called, go in there and buy the Johnson and, you know, children shampoo too. That's always a great thing because they shouldn't be using the same that we use. They need the gentle kind. You know, it doesn't burn the eyes and all that good stuff. So think about the children too on that. Our offertory sentence comes directly from our book of Ephesians this morning, so I'm going to read it. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children and live in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God.
Forever held.
your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks to them, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance. Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Okay. Peter, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 Hi, Jan. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Rob, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 Chris, the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. 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 Together. In the name of this congregation, we send you out bearing these holy gifts, that those to whom you go may share with us in the communion of Christ's body and blood. We who are many are one body, because we all share one bread and one cup. Amen. now standing together, if we would, as we're able, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Go forth to share the bread of life, Jesus Christ, with the world. Glad to hear it. Glad to hear it.